Yeah. So, sir, buying a dream home will be cheaper from April 1, as the GST Council has recently cut rates for under-construction projects as well as affordable houses. So, what is your take on the decision and how it can benefit a real estate buyer?
I think it's a tremendous story. No customer was ready to buy in Mumbai, for instance, paying 12% GST and 6% stamp duty. This postponement will stop and he'll be ready to come back into the market for the purpose of buying the house. So I think it's a very positive story from the consumer point of view. Not all developers will benefit from this because of input tax credit not being available, but that doesn't matter. I think in the long run, at least the liquidity issue of the industry may get mitigated.
Okay. And the GST on under-construction flat has been reduced to 5% without input tax credit from 12% earlier with the ITC. So what does it mean for a developer?
So as I said, it's not equally. It depends on the location, it depends on the land value, it depends on what is the cost of construction. The higher the land value as far as that is concerned, then the benefit will change. But all in all, if you tell me, the liquidity issue of the developer will definitely improve. Profitability, one cannot assess because every case is different.
So do you think the developer will pass on the cost in case of any rise in prices?
The markets don't have that strength in order to pass on any additional cost today. But the future is not here to say. That is a demand and supply issue. And prices are not being controlled. The question of GST is being capped to 5%.
Okay. So, sir, I was looking at some data. So, there are nearly 6 lakh unsold under-construction houses in the biggest 7 cities of India, of which 34% are priced below rupees 40 lakh. So do you think we will see sales of more homes in the budget category?
100%. This is exactly what I wanted to compliment the government for bringing in this for affordable housing, which is brought down to 1%. And stamp duties of that in the states of Maharashtra and Gujarat have been brought down to 1,000 rupees and 10 rupees. So I think that is a big story.
And how do you see cap of rupees 45 lakh for affordable housing?
The cap of 45 lakhs is good for the country, but not good for places like Mumbai and Delhi. So I think they need to relook at that prices.
And how do you see role of real estate sector in for economy and employment generation?
I think that's the biggest story. With the GDP growing at 7.2%, it can only continue to grow if housing and infrastructure grows. And also the question of employment. We are the second largest employer in India, or in any developing country. So I think the positive absorption, both from the agriculture sector and general economy, will be absorbed by housing and infrastructure if we continue to grow at that level.
Any message to the government after the GST rate cut?
I think we are very, very happy with the government to make this move in terms of making this paradigm happen. There are many issues in terms of tweaking the transition phase of that position relating to the old projects and new. And also they need to look at commercial properties in terms of leases, TDR and joint development agreement. So we have represented the same. Yes, we need to tweak some of the issues, but hats off to them. Good job.
How the real estate industry has changed during the past 5 years, and where do you see it in the next 5 years?
I think there are two parts to it. One, the transparency has definitely improved. So more information and data and commitment is done by the developers to the consumer. So I think that's a positive trend. But a lot of funding requirement has increased because of RERA and the escrowing of the money. And that is not easily available. So I think that's the negative as far as the economy is concerned for real estate. So we'll have to mitigate both these issues, which I think is positive in the long run.
Is the sector still facing a liquidity issue?
Oh, I think there's a big liquidity issue, especially after the ILFS crisis. And I think it's still continuing. But I think the intervention of RBI and National Housing Bank will make a world of a difference.
So for a home buyer, what advice do you give to them? Means what are they look into before selecting a broker and all?
I think the basic idea is to see track record of good people, and that track record is now easily available. Second, RERA documentation is quite intensive. One should make a check of all that. And before all that, you should see at least the previous projects and meet probably some of the consumers into this whole thing and find out how's the experience of the previous project which the developer has done. I think if you take these steps, you will certainly not make any mistakes and have a good investment and a good home.
Okay. And one last question. How do you see demand for commercial real estate?
Commercial real estate demand has definitely grown and will continue to grow with the increase in GDP. I'm very bullish.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving your time.